Hello students, welcome to the session. Today we are going to deal with ahara, that is the food, the traditional and conventional classification, which is very much related with the hydrotherapy. Here we are dealing with the second part, paper 2. So coming to the ahara, as per the naturopathy principle, we know that we have the traditional reference in the Bhagavad Gita, especially about the ahara, because here in shloka number 17 of adhyaya 6, Bhagavan Shri Krishna says that yukta ahara vihara. So that is what the naturopathy principle also says about yukta ahara, a particular combination of the food or a particular property of the food which is responsible for bringing the change in the body, can be used as a aseptic diet, which is being told in the hydrotherapy. So now we are learning about the aseptic diet, the diet which is not causing any sepsis, any changes, or any, you know, which doesn't give any room for the development of the bacteria or the pathogens. So that is what the concept of aseptic diet in hydrotherapy. So this can be considered as non-accumulating, you know, food particle, okay, which is properly eliminated and which helps for the body to maintain the homeostasis. So here in shloka number 6.17, he says about yukta ahara. Yukta ahara means the proper diet which is responsible for bringing the change in the patient. Okay, so that is very much related with the aseptic diet. So we will go through the aseptic diet later. So we will come back to conventional therapy, which is being, you know, told about the food as such. So whenever we say about the diet therapy or the food therapy, the modern method, it divides the food into various components like carbohydrates, fats, minerals, proteins, vitamins, etc. So is it possible for a person to have fat rich food only, or food which is more in fat, we can just say. We cannot just say food which has only the fat. So that's why many times we call it as fat rich or starch rich or carbohydrate rich, okay, or protein rich. So that means to say there are other contents in that particular food material which is bringing the change in the body, but dominantly there is some major component like fat or carbohydrate or protein. So that's why we call the food as fat rich, or, you know, we say that it is a combination of different other materials also. There can be little minerals, there can be little vitamins along with the more of fat or more of carbohydrate. So coming to hydrotherapy as such, we have to know about the diet therapy very, very crucially, because all our treatments that depends upon the food timings and gastric emptying time. So whenever person has food in his stomach, we are not supposed to give any of the treatments. That is how the food is being related to hydrotherapy. In naturopathy, basically we classify the food as uncooked and cooked food. So uncooked food is more preferred because it is a quite natural way of consuming the food and it is in the digestible form. But cooked food, it is more tastier and more palatable. So people do use cooked food for preparing different varieties of dishes. So even we can just use these cooked foods also in aseptic diet, because that is the culture, that is the tradition usually which is followed region wise or religion wise. That is why we have to use either cooked food or uncooked food at different timings. That is the principle of naturopathy. We should not combine the both. We have to say that if they are preferring the cooked food, have some choice to have the aseptic effect over the body for, I mean, related with the that particular disease condition, okay, right? So if we are going for cooked food, uncooked food, then go for uncooked variety of food, which is responsible for bringing out the, you know, changes back to normal, which has been already happened because of the disease process. So here the traditional texts, which is dealing with the food, especially the Bhagavad Gita, as I already mentioned, it says about the effect of the food on the body, and it classifies the food as sattvic, rajasic and tamasic food. So usually whenever we say sattvic, rajasic and tamasic food, we think that these three are very different from one another. But it is not like that. It is a combination of all these three in a food. But the dominant quality can be sattva, dominant quality can be rajas, dominant quality can be tamas. Now whenever we say it is sattva quality, it denotes the positive, pure effect over the body. So it is considered to be divine food. So it gives the pleasure for the person whenever it is being eaten. So that is what the sattva guna. So that is what the, you know, property of that particular food in the body. That is why it is called as sattva. Then rajas, the food which is having rajoguna, okay, it is actually the stimulating effect over the body. So it is considered to be, you know, controlling the human activity. It is considered to be stimulating the many of the body functions in the body. Okay, many of the functions in the body. So coming to the tamas as such, it is considered to be negative and impure food, which is responsible for lethargy in a person. So according to the effect of the food over the body, we have sattva, rajas and tamas. So the combination of sattva, rajas and tamas, it is very much helpful in treating the disease as such. So here the sattva guna, it is considered to be one of the desired effect over the body. Whatever may be the combination of the food, it is considered to be desired effect. That's why the sattva guna is given, I mean sattva food, which is responsible for sattva guna, is given utmost importance. So here in Bhagavad Gita we get one particular sloka which says that Ayu sattva balam arogya sukha priti vivardhanaha rasyaha snigdaha stiram hridyaha aharaha sattvika priyaha. So these are the qualities of sattvika ahara. So when food is taken, it should help in improving the ayu, that is length of the life, then sattva, the essence of the person, then bala, it is the strength of the person, arogya, health of the person. So these physical qualities are to be there for any food if it is being taken. So that is why in disease condition also, we have to help the person to overcome the disease process and have the arogya, that is the healthy condition in the body. So it will be having that particular effect, I mean that particular food will be having its effect over the mind also. That is what is being told as sukha priti vivardhanaha. So it helps to develop the positive emotions in the body. Person will be very, very comfortable, and along with the comfortability, he also will have the positive emotions like love, compassion and removing the hatredness, all those things. So that is why the food, whenever we prescribe in hydrotherapy, we say it is aseptic at the body level and aseptic at the mind level. So let us know about different types of food as it is being told in the Bhagavad Gita in next sessions. Thank you.